Why did we fall for you? Welcome back to another episode of the City Podcast. It's going to be episode 130. We are your hosts. I'm Tony, and I'm here with...
Roman.
And...
your boy, Eric.
Yes.
Hate that boy. And I hated that song. That was terrible.
Oh, you don't like the SoundCloud artist?
That was awful.
Nah, man.
You don't like the... I'm never going to ask you if you like Juice WRLD or anything like that.
There you go.
Dude, I like
now you're
the Boogie.
Hoodie with the Boogie.
It says new album's actually pretty decent. I've been jamming out to that one.
The names
are stupid.
Does it sound talking like that?
No.
Okay. You're just talking nonsense to him right now.
Oh, to Roman?
Yeah, that does not.
Sometimes I'll be like, what am I listening to? Because I have a Rap Caviar on Spotify.
Oh. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh man, this is a pretty edgy, pretty good beat song.
Okay.
And I go and look for it, and I was like, man, these fucking stupid names that new rappers have. Mm-hmm. Fucking just be like, at least try. At least try to get something. Now it's like Little Fucking Pump, Little Peep, Little Everything.
Little Dead.
It's Little Everything. Or
one of those peoples is a Little Dead.
Yeah.
I don't care. Anyways.
I think they're all dead. That's a hell of a drug.
They're stupid.
Hell of a drug. Like, come on, man. Take some pride, dude. How the fuck you do? But then again, I look at them, I was like, oh, that's why. I look at them, I was like, they look like pieces of shit.
Yeah, they're all heroin addicts.
And then opioids.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, do I really like their song, or do I look the beat? Turns out, like, 9 out of 10 times I like the beat. Like, if they would not rap, and they just had a producer put out the beat, I'd jam out to that all day.
For me, like, I need some lyrics to latch on to.
Yeah,
and not retarded ones like "Roses Are Red." I just want to die. Whatever the fuck he was saying. That's
not what it's.
Shit, that matter. I don't care. I think it's terrible. And plus, I'm over this fucking whole auto-tune bullshit.
Well, it's the emo face of hip hop right now.
I know, and I don't like it.
On the Downies.
I'm fine with emo. Like, I'm okay with, like, you know, the depression and all that. That's fine. That's what I listen to anyway, right?
Yeah.
But at least the ones I listen to, like, they at least try to play an instrument or, like, try to sing or try to have, like, a little something to the song. There it's just like, rah, nah, you just sound like a robot. Like, not even a good robot, first of all. Not like a cool fucking robot.
You know what they do? They have to sell that they're on drugs. Like,
they don't have to sell it. They're on drugs. It doesn't matter.
Because I was like
you don't get face tattoos and you're like a sober dude. Like, you just don't.
Oh, I've seen a lot of people.
Bullshit.
I've seen a lot of people.
Then if they're sober.
But they're seen people. The old Viners turn into, I don't know, whatever the fuck social media is.
Okay, but the thing is, they may be sober at that time, but when they got those face tattoos, they were fucking high as nutsacks.
Because, I mean, like,
that's weird, because nutsacks are so down low.
Yeah, they're on heroin, they're on downers.
They have to, like, sell expressions like, yeah, I'm on fucking downers and I can't even talk.
Yeah.
But coming from a guy who's taking downers, that doesn't happen. Like, 2 weeks ago,
You need them medically. They take them because...
Well, I overtook my dad's cancer pills.
Because
I was hurting, dude. This fucking weird-ass weather was fucking hurt. And I took one of my fucking dad's painkillers that he left behind. And I wasn't fucking slurring. But then again, I always want to slur my fucking words.
Yeah.
All I did was sleep. I was like, what the fucking time is it?
That's what they.
But
do.
They make me like sound like I was in slow motion or like if I can't carry a fucking conversation, so I was like, maybe I'm not the man in the right kind of drugs.
See, I had the opposite effect because when I tried those painkillers from that friend when I overdosed or semi overdosed,
look who's trying to sound emo.
I was super fucking sleepy and I was just like, ooh, I couldn't even drive. I mean, I tried.
Maybe because I'm used to them.
I think so.
They're a heavy dose of pills.
Oh yeah, you're an addict.
But then again,
sure.
I've taken like anti-anxiety and anti-depression, and those make me a fucking zombie. Mm. Again, I don't sound like, you know, I'm gonna fucking just like.
Because nobody's talking to you when you're asleep.
Probably, but that's all it made me was sleeping.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, just slept the fucking day.
I mean, that's what they do. And then eventually, like, if you just keep taking them, your tolerance goes up, so you're not. You don't just, like, you can function.
But do you sound like that? Because that is. You're right. I fucking hate what Lil Wayne created of rappers.
Yeah.
And they just sound like. They don't know how to talk. Mm-hmm. I was like, how are you
gonna don't know how to talk.
How are you going to call yourself a rapper? You can't fucking rap.
That's like the whole like breakdown with
but
like.
But they don't call them, a lot of them don't call themselves rappers. They call themselves artists or entertainers.
Yeah, but they're in the rap game. Because you tell them, all right, you're an entertainer. In the hip-hop game. You're not in a hip hop game. You're not a rapper. He's like, no, man, I'm totally a hip hop artist. I was like, same shit.
But the thing, like the
wouldn't it be pop though?
The thing is, like, The problem that I have with a lot of, like, new rappers, I'm pretty sure we've covered this at least 30 times.
Yeah.
The problem I have with new rappers is, like, they don't make their own beats.
Oh, they don't make their own anything.
Exactly. Like, they don't make their own beats.
It's like someone sending a package, they pick it up, they're like, okay, this is who you're going to be.
Exactly. And that's, like, my problem with
and
it. At least, like,
and everything makes them, you know.
I guess the same could be said about pop artists or boy bands and stuff like that.
Yeah. And again, like, I don't like any of that music either.
You don't like anything too commercial.
You don't like anything generated.
The commercial is not the right word.
I would say it's the proper word.
No, because, like, there's plenty of things that I like that are popular. Like, the bands that I listen to, like, Cody Cambry is a popular band. Is it as popular as other things? No. But they are a popular band. Like,
you used to like the popular stuff. Like,
I mean, they're technically
oh, Panic at the Disco. Like, boom, I like that. They're super popular, aren't they?
Was it?
Like, I liked Fall Out Boy for
Fall
a little
Out
bit.
Boy, that's
so like, the thing
so
is like
Fall Out Boy now.
No, they're terrible.
Because they.
Because
they went commercial. No, that's what
the thing about Fall Out Boy and Panic at the Disco is that. You separate them from, you know, whatever scene they're in.
Yeah.
And the dudes can still play their instruments.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, some hip-hop, some of these SoundCloud dudes can make beats and can do what they say.
Yeah.
I'm not going to take their side all the time, but
it just,
Mac Miller produced...
Seems like you do.
Oh, he likes it.
Mac Miller produced his own music, and mm-hmm. he genuinely did all the music
Mac Miller wasn't part of the SoundCloud scene. He was an OG. Well, people don't remember him being an OG.
But
at least, like,
he signed a lot of the SoundCloud people.
The thing is, like, at least I can listen to Mac Miller, and he has, like, at least something to say. Now, does that, like... Not all the time. Like I still like fucking dumb.
Hard to say who,
I still
who
like dumb shit like Run the Jewels. Like, they don't really have a message. Just like, we fuck bitches, we get money, we have fun. That's
that
all.
That is the message.
And like, that's fine. But I have to hear it.
You know what it is? Is that all these new young cats are afraid to sound like they want to sound because they won't get money. Or they won't get popular unless they sound like the fucking wave, that trend that's going
Snoop
on.
Snoop Dogg I just saw that GGN right now.
So like,
where he's like,
they're afraid to be like, this is who I want to be musically.
Yeah.
Because they won't fit into the
trend. What's trending? So
yeah, exactly. Funny. Because they have no talent. Whoa. Like, that is a problem. Like, if you had talent, right?
You would make it on your own merits.
And you could make it. I'm not saying that you are that. It's a possibility.
I think it's the instant gratification. You go with what's trending so you can make that money. So you
exactly.
Can
like
which is
it's
cool,
it's a different different mindset.
Get your money.
But
babe.
When you like, I have a big problem with it because like, I love music, right?
I just realized that fucking Roman's like hella triggered.
Like
the start by the 8 seconds we played at the beginning of this fucking podcast.
Well,
It was supposed to go with the Valentine flow.
You ain't gonna like the last 8 seconds.
I'm sure I won't.
It was supposed to be our Valentine's episode.
You know what? Sometimes the Valentine's is a little bit of hate. All right,
it's a lot of hate.
You fuck. But. Oh God! Like the thing is, like you were telling me, like, oh man, you look dead. You look like shit. Like before the episode, I was like, I'm just tired. Right,
and then he's like, I'm tired of hearing these crap ass rappers.
And then you fucking you assault my fucking eardrums with shit. It's like it's literally like you took a shit in your hand and you smashed it in my ear. How am I not gonna address it?
That's a good song. I like it.
I know it sounded horrible.
That sounded bad, dude.
You know what I fucking hate, too? Mm. In the new fucking South America? Mm. Is the I love you, bro?
Hey, 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 hey.
No, no, but no, but it comes out on music.
Now that you're fucking alt right Nazi.
No, oh, well, I got a ratchet in that.
I was about to say fucking Robbie wants to make emo great again.
Yeah, exactly.
No, in this soft fucking America, even the hip hop artists are like, I love you, bro, but I have to fucking talk shit about you. I love you, bro, but I'm gonna fuck your bitch. I love you, bro, but I'm gonna steal your money.
Okay, so.
I was like, motherfucker, just, you say, you know what? I stole your money. I fucked your bitch.
Yeah.
Look, I'm gonna talk shit about you.
Look, what a Tupac. He put it in a fucking song.
I hate that shit. I was like, I
multiple
hate
songs.
I hate
Tupac,
when
Tupac was the realest one.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
I fucking hate that whole "I love you" shit, but I'm gonna fucking stab you in the back. I just it triggers me. It's
it's like the second time you use trigger. Calm that shit down, boy.
Yeah, boy. But that is I understand why people like looking at her. Like, she has some fake titties, fake ass. Everybody likes it.
Yeah.
I cannot stand that bitch.
Who's
and like,
Cardi B?
Yeah.
She's
and
a
then
real
all these bitches that are like, oh, she too fucking real. You don't even fucking know. She just says what comes to her mind. Well, her mind is fucking retarded. I don't want to hear anything that comes out of it.
Hearing her talking normal, it's hard to hear because she has like this. She does it on purpose, where she, I don't know, and it's just like, okay,
like,
I get it. Like, you have braces, I know she had fucked up teeth.
Yeah.
Oh,
and she
did.
Got them fixed.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't know how fucked up they were. I never
you
really
don't understand,
up.
Man. She stripped her way to fame.
It's just, I don't understand the, I don't care.
I mean,
like, that's
to
fine,
do that,
whatever.
But she ain't rapping. You know?
That's fine, I don't
but
care.
She,
it's just.
She doesn't have a flow like Cardi B.
Cardi B doesn't really have her own flow either. From what I've noticed, she reuses her same flow from other songs. And
repetition,
also,
man. Repetition.
And that's why,
she,
like, I'm just
copies,
like,
man.
Like, people are really
songs.
Dumb.
They are, man.
People are dumb that they like this shit. Because I love dumb shit, too. Don't get me wrong. Like, it's not like everything I fucking love is, like, fucking awesome. And you should, like, take everything I say with the fucking sugar. It's just...
I'm not sure what that means.
What the fuck is wrong with people that they latch onto bullshit like this? I don't understand
dude,
it anymore.
Where do you explain this? Bro. Everybody wants to be part of the it crowd. Everybody wants to be part of the popular circle. Everybody wants to feel like they're part of something. Mm-hmm. And what enjoying these trends is that. There's a lot of people that don't like the fucking music of all the Little Pumps, Little Peeps, whatever. Mm-hmm. But they're like, they're going to jam onto it because that's what's hot. That's what people are doing. That's what they're a part of something.
Inclusion
and again, they're afraid of being alienated because nobody wants to be fucking lonely, dude. Nobody wants to be put aside. So
I mean,
what happens is you fucking put a little something in your ear and death yourself out a little
but,
bit and you join the jam.
But here,
or you find something you like,
but,
like about it.
But here's the perfect thing, and this is like one of the good things, and we'll try to switch it from fucking hate into to something else.
To Valentine's
moment? To maybe a little bit of love is like, there is people out there, like, no matter how fucking alienated you may feel and, like, oh, I don't like this, I don't like that, this is there's a specific circle. There is people that are going to like that. And with the magic of the internet, you can actually do that. You can start focusing on that. Like, I don't understand this.
But then the problem comes out. I guess from there it goes, you know, I don't like that, but the people that truly like it or the other people... that will go with it.
Mm-hmm.
It's mob mentality. You can't say nothing bad about them. Fanatics are crazy.
Yeah.
So then that's how you start.
Yeah, you by just saying what you
like
said
mm-hmm.
probably offended a lot of people.
No, I mean,
care.
Not a lot of people listen to this, but
yeah. No, yeah. I mean, yeah, but like,
but,
if we're, say we're popular. Say
uh-huh.
we're a banging
uh-huh.
Joe Rogan fucking
uh-huh.
podcast.
Uh-huh.
And what you just said
uh-huh.
would bring so much fucking negativity
uh-huh.
and so much hate to yourself just by saying, I don't like the fucking crappy SoundCloud rappers.
Okay, but, okay, and in this fucking make-believe world...
Oh,
where,
those not make-believe. You
where,
want... You
where,
you know
where,
how I said South America is like a thing?
No,
like,
no.
And shit?
Yeah.
Did you hear what happened to Liam Neeson?
Yeah.
That
no,
the motherfucker
no,
came
no,
hey, but you know what? Liam Neeson did it right, and black people are like, yeah, we respect that.
Okay.
That's the thing. He had to... apologize
mm-hmm.
for thoughts he had
mm-hmm.
10 years ago for tragic events that
I'm
happened in his
pretty
life.
Sure
yeah.
it wasn't
just
thoughts.
It was just
thoughts.
Fucking
it
thoughts.
Was, no, because he was out looking for a
but
black
nothing
person.
Happened.
Because there were no black people.
And he didn't go around saying, oh, I wish a nigga would fucking come at me. He just thought about it. He carried a gun with him. Mm-hmm. He went to the bad part of Ireland where, you know, shit would happen. He was like, I hope someone comes in, fucks with me. Mm-hmm. So I could kill someone.
Yeah.
That was, those are fucking thoughts and shit that didn't happen. And people be like, racist. Mm-hmm. You're a fucking racist. Mm-hmm. You deserve your movie to get shut down. Yeah. They take away his fucking premiere for fucking thoughts and words that happened to him. Mm-hmm. Like a decade.
It was a...
That's how fucking racist. Me Too soft bullshit's happening. That it, now you have to apologize for shit that didn't happen.
It's not that. And it's not even that. It's the fact that for some reason, people are taking away redemption.
You think so?
Yes. People, by the fact of just... maybe it's an instant gratification thing. Like, where people like want an impact now. Mm-hmm. Like, they want it instantly, and they want it done. They don't care about the like, everything that happens down the line, the ramifications.
We are the generation of the fucking instant ramen, yeah, instant noodles.
Exactly, but, like, the thing is, you, like, this came up with the James Gunn thing, too. Like, where you had the tweets from way back when, where they were, like, homophobic or transphobic, whatever the hell. The thing is...
Who's James Gunn?
The director of Guardians of the Galaxy.
Ah.
That he...
Oh, yeah, he was the guy who said a bunch of stuff for Shaw Factor, right?
Yeah, yeah, that's exactly it. But, he like, people can't change. Like, people can't change their views on things that they may have said. I don't think I'm the same person that I was 10 years ago.
You're more hateful.
Exactly. Yeah, and sometimes it's not for the better, you know what I mean? Better. Yeah, exactly. Sometimes it's for the good or the bad. But, yeah, like, there is always a chance that somebody can... prove themselves to be a better person.
True.
And the thing is that people just outright say the shit because they want change immediately, and it ruins someone's life. Well, and maybe, like, with his life it's not ruined, but, like, what happened to the redemption story? Apparently we all love it in movies and shit, but we don't like it in real life.
I think what it is, it's two things. People love being, okay, I made that person apologize.
Yeah, the power.
It makes them feel superior. And two, they have what we call now the comic book mentality.
Yeah.
That once a hero, always a hero, once a villain, always a villain.
Yeah.
There is no change in people.
Yeah.
That eventually, you know, they're going to revert to that hateful, or that's who they really are, and they're just hiding it now for, you know, for the fame and the money. And all that bullshit. That people don't really fucking change. And I just think it's more that people love to make people apologize. To shame them. To make them feel bad. To say, I found that villain. Now he's in fucking... has to apologize to the world for something he was going to do. Something he did before.
So you mean to tell me that I feel like Bo-Sap where he's scrimmaging with like Goldberg. And he's like, I made him say he's sorry.
Exactly.
Like, so it's...
They have that, that biblical one where you bring down the fucking giant with the fucking...
David and Goliath.
Yeah, it's the whole David and Goliath. They want to be the David that beat the Goliath. Mm-hmm. They want to be like... It makes him feel better being, look, I did this, I uncovered this. Mm-hmm. Like the dude with James Gunn, the one who made the tweets public again. They gave him an interview. He's like, yeah, man, he was a monster back then. I want people to recognize him for who he really is. Which is not. It's not true because people can change. Well, at least I think people can change.
I'd like to think people can change, at least. At least some people.
I've given
people... Everybody should get a shot. Like, isn't that what, like... Isn't that...
The Bible's all about...
Not even that. Like, isn't that what, like, prison was kind of founded on? Maybe not now. Maybe now it's a business because it's privately owned and shit.
Back then.
But back then, it was like, look...
When they got originally created.
Exactly. You had a crime... If that crime was not punishable by death and something that you can do while you were in jail, like you served your time, that there was a redemption there. Like you could, they put you away so that you can possibly change and make a better impact.
I thought it was to keep those bad people away and let them rot in the place so they died.
No, it was supposed to be redemption. You were supposed to do your time,
come
out and become a changed person.
It's supposed to be justice, you know what I mean? And sometimes justice is at the end of a blade, and sometimes it's by...
That's why our justice system it fits the crime.
Yeah.
Not everything... You don't go to jail and be like, instant death.
Yeah, exactly.
No, it depends on the crime you do. Yeah. there's beliefs that you could be redeemed, you could be fixed, you could change by taking away everything you have as a free person, right?
You go time out.
Yeah, you go to time out, you learn that you miss these things, that you want these things.
But what you'll kill for it.
But what happened is that...
In some cases, yes.
What I think that happened is that prison just got overpopulated and it became just criminal circuit.
Now, it's
a publicly owned, it's a business.
Yeah, it's not public, it's private. It's a private sector.
No, it's a publicly known that, you know, you go in now to do more crime type.
Yeah, exactly, yeah, that's the thing.
But, it became a business, it became money.
Exactly, just like everything else, but,
And they stopped caring, because, you know, it's like the whole mentality of how a teacher could only teach a small group and not a big group. Mm-hmm. Like, the more students a teacher has, the less she teaches. Mm-hmm. It's the same thing. Our prisons became overpopulated where they don't care about, you know, fixing them. Yeah. They don't care about the whole...
Rehabilitation
uh-huh. of the criminal.
Yeah.
It stopped being about that. It's just like, hold them there. And it became Eric's mentality. Mm-hmm. Let them rot. Yeah. Let them rot in prison.
Yeah.
And you were not going to fix them. And then it became that mentality that he's a fucking criminal.
A lot of people have been wrongfully accused. I'll give them that.
Yeah, like that.
It's an imperfect system.
For sure.
I don't know the ins and outs of it, so I can't really speak on it too bad.
No, but like everything else, it's you can have an opinion on it.
Yeah, you can have an opinion.
And that's the thing. It's just like... And going back to the original thing, like, where in the scenario where we were popular and we... when we had the Joe Rogan cap on.
Yeah.
Like, honestly, it's my opinion of that music. Now... Should my opinion influence your whole life? It shouldn't, and there are people that are going to do that.
There's a lot of people that are opinions.
Exactly.
They do it in person.
Exactly, but why you should be able, at a certain age, I'm not blaming, you know... make your own opinion. I have my opinion on a subject. Why don't you listen to it, especially like with music? Why don't you listen to it and make your own opinion?
Because now, it goes back to full circle to that high mentality.
But yeah, exactly.
They don't want to stand out.
And the thing is, I don't give a fuck about...
What's that? That fucking crowd mentality.
Yeah.
I'd rather be with the it crowd.
Mentality.
The mob mentality. There you go.
Yeah, mob
mentality. I'd rather fucking be part of the mob than being the one they're going to oppose.
Yeah.
Suddenly, if you're not part of the mob, you're part of the problem.
You'd rather be the mob than Frankenstein.
Yeah, because they're going to fucking turn the flames...
Frankenstein's monster.
Frankenstein's monster.
They're going to turn the pitchforks at you. Because you fucking said, you know what? You guys are wrong.
Hey, that's not what I believe. Everybody likes a good martyr, you know what I'm saying?
That's the thing, though. Martyrs usually die.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to end up dying.
I'm very frustrated about a lot of things like that.
It's Dude, just,
why can't people make their own decisions, and why don't people read up on these things themselves?
They're afraid, though.
But the thing is, like, why do you have to live your whole life in fucking fear of people not liking you? Like, people aren't gonna like, there's gonna be some people that just don't like you at all. It doesn't matter how good you are to that person.
Because it's a primal thing. It's a human thing. It's a primal thing to be accepted. It's a primal thing to be in a group.
Mm-hmm.
It's the whole pack mentality. It's the whole, I want to be part of something.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody wants to be the dude in the middle of nowhere alone.
I guess people...
And I know you could say... I know you said, hey, man, with technology now, you could go and find that group that has the opinions like you.
Mm-hmm.
You could find them, but that is so much hard work. Are lazy now. The people don't want to go search out like-minded individuals. Because it's easier to be part of their crowd.
But the thing is, like, you're not... Like, the misconception is, like, I'm so different. No one understands me. And it's like, bullshit. There's going to be somebody that understands you. And you can start, if you want... To have some form of interaction, whether it be through the internet or like in real life,
or just learn to be by yourself,
or just learn to I don't understand the lonely part, being lonely every once in a while sucks, like when you don't have anybody to talk to or anything like that. I'm not talking about relationships, I'm talking about friends.
Just in general,
like when you're lonely sometimes it hurts, like it's just like, man, this sucks. But the thing is, like, I'm not scared of hurt. I'm not scared of any of that shit. It doesn't. That doesn't matter.
No, I mean, it's weird because I think Eric's like that. And that was with a group of people. Was either fucking dumb fart jokes, or it was bitches that, you know, turned to rape jokes. But you never really had a conversation about anime or games.
I didn't know him too much in high school.
Until you found out that, like, John likes anime. Yeah. Until you found out Daniel liked games and shit like that. But those are the people that stayed around because, you know, they got to meet and greet the real Eric.
Yeah, because we were just like, yeah, that's cool, but, like, what else you got? Like, what is you about?
That's the thing. But I don't know.
You lost me. Yeah. I never once not said that I wasn't into
But you never did anime. Say it, though.
Yeah, I did.
And the mom is like, why are you watching
this? I mean, again, that's his opinion.
That's like, my opinion of you from the outside circle.
Oh, okay. I mean, I'm just
from the outside view, from
that's why Hot Topic Eric wore his anime shirts and shit.
No, remember in school with Eric was nothing but rock bands.
That too.
It was into, like, the trend of the weave that you're like, okay, I'm going to be a weave. But he's always been there.
I don't know about the trend of the weave, but...
that happened around one of your high school years? When not anime after. And the geek became cool?
Nah, it started like for us, it started like in middle school.
Yeah.
Because that's when like Toonami was like the shit, the you know what I mean? That's
when, but it took a while though, because it was like when Naruto hit.
But that's the thing is like he's a true dyed in the wool kind of weeb. You know what I mean? Like he's been there since. He's like the bane of fucking weebs.
Yeah, but he didn't express it out.
Yeah.
He didn't express it out of confidence until a while.
You were molded by it.
I didn't see a real girl till I was a man, and it was blinding.
Clash the head last
record. Like call back to the old city podcast. I used to steal cable just to watch Dragon Ball Z.
Yeah. Like that.
We
that's
used to
the
go
thing.
To the house next door, steal the cable, fucking bring the wire in through a wire, watch Tsunami.
It was never stolen. We're like, hey neighbor, can we borrow your cable? And they're like, yeah.
Splice. Just fucking.
They're like,
snip.
Shit, we stole it from the fucking city. It's right there.
I remember that
another splice, and we're like, cool.
I remember one of the neighbors go, hey, you know, we have a cousin go to the thing and just fix it for you. He's like, nah, he just wants to see Tsunami. And then the day the neighbors moved away and they cut the cable, it was like,
no.
We need cable.
No.
The cable guy saw something, he's like, this ain't right. He's like, hey, we all borrowed cable. I was like, what?
No.
I thought this was regular cable. I thought this was we all got dish.
I remember that, dude. When we got cable, like, on the fucking for real level, the cable guy went up, he came down. Like, have you guys ever seen anybody go up there? I go, no, man, it's pretty tall to get up there.
Yeah, man, we have ladders, but they ain't that tall, you know what I mean?
He's like, there's something off of it. It's like, dude, I don't know, this is the first time we've had cable.
Yeah, we've been poor all our lives.
All my life, I had to fight, nigga.
Oh, man.
We're hungry up in here.
Yeah, we were Kendrick before Kendrick.
Until the cable guy, like, hey man, can you hurry up? Tsunami comes out at 7. How do you know that you never had cable?
That's what my friends told me in high school. They got money.
Look, bro, we still got fucking. You have like this like old TV guide from like 87. says right here.
I forgot about the TV guide.
Yeah, remember that fucking the little bullshit thing? Yeah. There was a book that came out every month. That would tell you what is coming out.
Before the channel came out.
Exactly.
And I missed the fucking channel that had the weather on top and had all the listings to all the shows.
Fucking magicians worked.
Yeah, dude, it was crazy. Like, time. I don't know if you can, like, it's not like insanely, like we're, like it's not like we're like old or anything like that. It's just like, oh, that's an insane thing to tell, like, your nieces. Like, did you know that instead
said,
of like,
you, you mean you hit the info button? No,
there was no info button.
My niece is into TikTok, new Vine, and someone made a TikTok about Channel 99, and she told me, I don't get this. Why is it funny? I was like, I'm gonna explain it, but no one was the struggle, was it? Scramble porn,
them fucking scrambly legs.
Oh man, I just felt really fucking old.
I think I see a nickel.
Exactly.
Back when Nickelodeon became the porn channel, the porn channel became Nickelodeon.
Remember, like, you know, like through the waves and the static, you would fucking like get, like there would be you could watch it for an hour and there'd be like a 3-second clip of like clear titties and you'd be like fucking trying to bang it out as quickly as you could.
You burn it in your brain. You know how bitches be like, it's gotta come real quick. Yes, we were fashioned to do that, bro.
Yeah, man, dude, we were trained.
Man, we were molded by it.
That's just gonna be the joke for today. Fucking everything molded by it.
Yeah, the struggles. You know what I wish the fucking... You remember that channel where you
called... Love.
No, there was a channel where you called in, the box, mm-hmm. to get your music video. Yeah, yeah. Ah, fucking... I miss music videos.
I do.
I miss VJs.
Yeah, dude.
Carson Daly, where have you gone?
And I know they're like, oh, YouTube's full of music videos. And now you have to go look for your shit.
You're such a fucking bitch.
I'm part of the fucking problem now.
Yeah, you are. You don't want to like all this shit music. And
I don't like... Yeah, you know what? I do like shit music.
You like some shit music.
But I can't myself liking all these little peoples. All the little Uzi birds.
And also, so now, not only are you bigoted.
Yeah, not bigoted.
Tony,
right there.
Anthony,
you know, bigoted. I'm gonna
for an orphan, you sure do hate a lot of kids.
Right?
Maybe because I am an orphan-ass nigga.
I never had anything, so I'm going to hit on everybody that has something.
But you got in everything when he got picked up by mama.
Is it truly mine, though? Is it truly mine?
Nothing's really yours because you don't fucking have a job.
I do have a job. That's a problem. But anyways.
Proof.
I have a W-2. A paycheck stove.
Anybody can have a W-2.
Fuck you. You see the shit?
Miguel from fucking Mexico got a W-2.
Miguelito.
Actually has an I-99. Everybody who's illegal knows what's up.
So, back to the original topic of the show.
So, Valentine's.
Valentine's.
Yay!
I do hate shit other than hate.
No, I do have the day off, and I guess...
You gonna go on a date with John?
I mean, yeah, and I'm gonna actually record with you, too, so you're part of it.
This guy's going on a date and never recording porno. Gross.
Gross. That's gross.
But yeah, that's gonna be my Valentine's Day.
I was listening to last week's podcast.
Uh-huh.
And you're just... One of you, I don't know who it was, said, I just had that women bitch mentality that I want to find someone that just has to be special.
Eric did. I said it was a young man's way of looking at it.
Now he's a bitch.
And that fucking bothered me like all week. I was like,
because he's a bitch.
Do I really have? Because the running joke in my house is that I do women's work. Yeah. So I'm the woman.
Rosita.
Like, yeah, like my older brother.
He's a bitch too.
He got here, right? And we made a soup he likes. He got here from work, and I served him. And I usually serve dinner to the people in my house. Mm-hmm. Instead of saying, you know, thank you, his first comment is like, I'm going to have to marry you off. You're ready. You cook, you clean, you wash, you take care of the kids. And I already had that in my head, that shit from the pocket. I was like, mm-hmm. So I was like,
man, fuck you. You stabbed him.
No, I was like, do I really have fucking a woman mentality?
Yeah, you do.
You know how we're...
Well, women are empowering, so, you know, you try and flip that.
Yeah, no, you know how
but
we're...
But you're no better than that because you're still just a man.
You know how they say you're a product of your surroundings, and, you know, I do house bitch work, and I do women's job, and I was like, what the fuck? But then, I was listening to a fucking Will Smith interview.
Uh-huh.
And he has the same mentality I do. But he explained it in a manly way.
Okay.
He's like, I don't fuck around a lot. Cause he didn't. He was when he got his fame and shit. He had a wife, and then he divorced and he got what's the name of his name?
Jada
Pickerson.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's not Smith. Jada Pickett. Yeah.
And he's like, oh, I needed someone special. I needed someone to connect. And he's, you know, and he's like, it's because I live for women. Mm-hmm. Women motivate me.
Yeah.
And I was like, I started thinking about it. It's like, I think that's what I need. I think I need motivation to do shit, and even down to fucking women.
We'll find you a good man.
Like, if I had a fucking, you know, a girl say, you know, you gotta do this, I probably would do it.
Mm-hmm.
I would, if she, you know, motivation.
Mm-hmm.
And I just started thinking about it more and more of all the shit we've done. Mm-hmm. That I'm an unmotivated person.
Yeah.
Like, if I have a prize at the end of the rainbow, or like the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow, mm-hmm. I would get shit done. Mm-hmm. I was thinking about it. Remember we were playing fighting games?
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, you're never going to beat me. Mm-hmm. And I started learning combos until at least I got one game off you.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, okay, doom, damn. And I was like, I need constant motivation. Mm-hmm. Well, when you started this podcast, you told me one of the things in your bucket list was to get at least one song into iTunes. Mm-hmm. Or you wanted to hear yourself on iTunes.
Mm-hmm.
And I did that. I go, hey, Rome, look, you're on iTunes and shit. Mm-hmm. I went, because a lot of people, when they started doing this podcasting, all they did was either go to SoundCloud or another app that was popular back then.
Yeah.
Now there's like 20 of them. And I was like, oh, I went an extra mile. I started fucking reaching out. I started figuring out a way of fucking getting shit into iTunes and shit. And I was like, oh, okay, I did it.
Mm-hmm.
But once I reached that goal, everything, I kind of just stopped and just became, what is it called? When you just fucking coast.
Mm-hmm.
You go with it. And I was like, oh, shit. And I don't think about it. All the stuff I ever had, it was a goal.
Mm-hmm.
Like, when I ever needed something, like, oh, my fucking PS4 broke and I didn't have cash.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man, I found shit to sell, how to get money in order to get the shit I wanted.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, man, fucking Will Smith was right. Some people are just, you need motivation.
Yeah.
And it comes down to women, too. If a fucking girl would say, hey, man, lose weight. Because I had a girl be like, hey, man, lose weight. And we could do that. I was like, cool. I was losing weight.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, man, I need that. I need fucking someone to be like, keep pushing or not. I'm going to be okay with the way I live. And that's what he said.
Yeah.
And then he was like, I was okay fucking just living the life I was.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, if I didn't have no motivation, that was me. That was, mm-hmm. I was like, yeah, I'm the same way.
Yeah, okay.
I just thought it was something. I was like, so there are people out there that, you know, like, they think that way.
No,
like,
no, for sure.
But the thing is, who's mad at a girl who got a sugar daddy who's a real one.
But, okay, but like, that's the thing is, like, we weren't talking about, like, oh, like, you, like, you want to wait for a particular person that mm-hmm. you'd want to do that with, or what have you. No, there's nothing there. What I was saying is that there's certain things that you're looking at that only bothers people when they're young, and that's pretty much it. Like, the whole, like, How many people have you, like, fucked? Or, like, how many of my friends have you fucked and all that kind of stuff? Like, the friends thing, it may be different. Like, that's mm-hmm. that's a little different because those are your friends. But when it comes to, like, how many people you fucked, like, before me, that doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. Like,
The
numbers thing doesn't matter. Like, the mm-hmm. thing is, like, were you at least safe about it? Like, do you have anything I should know about mm-hmm. before we do anything? That's a whole other matter entirely. Okay. But, like, the number, like, the whole, like, how many people you've slept with and all that kind of shit, that's a young man's way of thinking where you're, because why should that matter if you're with her right now? If she's with you right now, why does it matter what happened in the past? Because it, for me, it doesn't matter. Like, you're here now.
The past kind of defines you.
And yeah, there's the whole thing, like, oh, history will repeat itself mm-hmm. and things like that. But that's why if you're willing to, like, if you're willing to work it out with that person, whatever issue,
ain't no one didn't change that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, boy.
The thing is, like, when you're young, you just see that number. You're like, well, fuck you, you're a fucking whore, and it's just like it's just an emotional response to it. When
it's an insecure response at that, because he's like, oh, she's got more practice than I do.
For sure, not even that. Maybe it's just an insecure thing, like, oh, well, I'm not even going to be the fucking best dude to fuck her. Like, you want to be the best, I guess, in her eyes or
that's
something.
A man thing, though, isn't it? That you always really want to be the fucking best of anything?
No.
You want to make sure that the girl you're with, you're like, you want to guarantee she's going to stay with you, and you're like, you have to be the best.
You can't guarantee that.
You're real hateful.
I'm just saying you can't guarantee it.
You can't guarantee it. The thing is, like, there is gonna be other things at factor that you're not looking at. Mm-hmm. Like, you have to think about it like from like another way, and maybe it's where like there are people say, like, oh, the chick way of thinking about things. Maybe that does pay off in the end because you can kind of, like, get into the headspace and kind of talk it out. Well, I mean, that can be used for good or evil because you can manipulate through that way, or you can actually do that. Exactly, yeah. But the thing is, like, the whole, like, maybe waiting for somebody or, like, you know, holding out for the person that you'd really like or something like that. There's not a problem with... I don't have a problem with that. What I have a problem with is somebody having something that was not in your control and having a problem with that. Because, like, that whole numbers thing is bullshit. And, like, do you want to be the best?
Well, like I said, I went back to listen. The number stuff, at the end of the day, it doesn't fucking matter. It's the friend stuff. It's the certain stuff that I think I was inside more focused on. Until this day, until now, shit hasn't changed in a week.
Yeah.
That if I fucking find a girl and she finds out she's been with a friend I know, or a couple, or a cousin of mine, or anybody in the family, I'd be like, no, I can't be with you because of that. And that's just me, though. That's how I function. That I don't want...
You're not high function.
I don't want someone to share that with me. I don't know, it's weird. Okay. Like a fucking... I don't know how to explain it, but...
You don't... But, I, like...
It's mine.
It's all mine. Just, like...
But there's other people that have shared it, though.
True. I don't know them. I don't talk to them.
But it's...
They're not part of my inner circle. They're not part of my family. Mm-hmm. They can't...
You don't want to know if your cousin got a bigger peepee than you.
It's not even that. It's not even on my half. It's on the half of the girl. I don't know what it is. It's like... It's
drama?
Like,
is it the drama?
No, but, it's not the drama. It's that whole mentality. I know how your girl looks naked.
But the thing is,
and the shit we done, or I don't want to know. Like a guy comes and is like, "Hey, your girl nasty because we did this and this and that." Because maybe she changed. Maybe she's not singing like that. And then it starts being okay. Is it me? Did you change for me? The things you don't do no more and shit like that. Again, at the beginning of the conversation of this fucking podcast was like, can people be redeemed? Can people change? Mm-hmm. Now you start asking all these fucking questions.
Are we talking about like if she
say she was fucking down, do all this crazy bullshit, right?
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. And suddenly she doesn't do it no more.
Okay.
And it became the last person she was with was a cousin of yours, a friend of yours, right? And you used to hear this all the stories, or you still hear those stories, or you fucking they remind you, it's like, hey man, does she still do this thing? Or is she still fucking crazy like she used to be? And then now you'll be like, okay, why did she change? Is it a bad thing? Is it her? Is it me? It's a lot.
But that's the thing. Is like, you.
It's a bad rom com in my head.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
But life isn't a rom com.
But that's the way I think, though.
There's a way that you think, and then there's reality, and reality isn't like that.
But that could be in my
There's a possibility. Anything's a possibility. I'm not taking that away.
Well, I mean. we have a couple of cousins that, you know, they dated each other, and I hear them fucking talking, and it comes like that, and I was like, I don't want that for me. Just don't want that.
We had cousins that dated each other.
Yeah,
fucking gross.
You forget that our family is a lot. They're not inbreeds, but it gets really fucking sketchy.
Shut the fuck up. You're making this look bad, bro.
Oh, no, it's weird because, you know, one side of the family kind of met the other side of the family, and they brought their brothers and sisters, and you know how it gets fucking messy by doing this shit. But they're not related by blood. They're just like, they're my cousins. Like, my cousins are dating me. It's weird. It's hard to explain.
I'm sure that does play a factor with,
but just like I said,
with it. Though the thing is, if somebody's if my family is talking to me like that, oh man, I fucking did her in the ass, she fucking blew me right afterwards, I'd be like, hey man, I'm not talking about this with, like, I just shut it down. Like, shut the fuck up.
You know how I shut it down? By not dating the girl.
That's true. Like,
that's the ultimate, I don't want.
And that's a probability, but what if you don't know? Now,
why would you take away
What if you don't know when you are...
Know.
But what... Oh, shut up. What if you don't know about... You don't know that this girl, like, knew your family, and then it comes out later. But you're already dating and shit.
I would break up with her.
That's retarded.
That's who I am, though.
I mean, I guess.
And you know, the thing is, though, people won't stay quiet about that. Especially in family.
Yeah.
Like, we still have the whole where my grandma knows everything kind of deal.
Yeah.
She's like, weren't you over here as novia?
Yeah.
And he's like, you were? She's like, oh, shit. I'd be like, all right, we're done. Just simple as that. But that's just me. That's my mentality.
Yeah.
Like, say you fucking met a girl that used to go out with your brother. And you didn't know that she used to go out with your brother for some fucking reason, you know. But your mom did. He's like, hey, weren't you your fucking my other son's girlfriend for a bit? And she's like, so you wouldn't care? No? I don't care.
He has a wife. And he has kids that he loves. What the fuck do I care?
I don't know,
because,
man.
Again, it's not like she's gonna, like, unless I completely fuck up and so does he, where, like they end up, like, cheating with, on each, like, they end up cheating on me or her. That's a possibility. Don't get me wrong.
You give them a chance to reconnect. And it's fucking...
Nah, but I've seen Roman's brother. If a girl broke up with him, it's probably for the best.
But the thing is, like...
you see, you want to put that out there. At least that's me. Like I said...
But, again...
I have a bad brain.
I just don't give a fuck about the past. Like, again, you can change from that, so I don't care. Like, when it comes... Because at that point, I'm just degrading this woman. By thinking like, oh, well, she was a fucking whore and now she's just with me, so what the fuck does that mean? You're just degrading her in your mind.
She won't give it
you're not respecting
like,
her at all.
I know that. I know my way of thinking is bad.
So
that's
like,
the way my way of thinking. I ain't gonna change it, though.
You could,
like,
though.
Like, me, if, like, I would never, ever go out with one of the people you've gone out with.
Okay,
like, any of your fucking ex-girlfriends or anything. Even close, it was like, hey, man, I dated her like 10 years ago. Nope. Not for me.
Okay.
That's weird.
When they introduce you to people, like, one of the things I always fucking ask people is like, hey, you know someone that would go out with a fat, ugly motherfucker? Let me know. But if I knew you used to go out with them, I wouldn't talk to her. It's the way I function. It's the way I am.
I guess. I mean, I just don't get it. It's kind of one of,
it's one of those things you won't ever get. But
I just won't ever get. And I think I could understand maybe when I was younger.
I think it's a matter of pride thing, because... our homeboy, I asked him, I was like, hey, man, if y'all end up breaking up, fucking let me get the scraps. And he's like, you don't want my scraps, bro. I was like, well, you got something? He's like, no, but come on, you don't want to do that. I'd be like, you don't know me, dog. I'll fucking take the scraps. They call me Scrap Captain, bro. That's a shout out to fucking Deadly Sins, Seven Deadly Sins.
Okay, fair enough. But it's whatever. I mean, that's your way of thinking. I'm not going to try to change it just because... At the end of the day,
Will Smith did not have a part about this. He just said, "I need to motivate a girl to motivate this shit."
I completely agree. I think everybody in this room has a problem with motivation.
Oh yeah.
Where we need an end goal in sight.
Yep.
In order for us to do things, it's a shit way of thinking, but maybe
I'm pretty sure if I had a fucking girlfriend in my life now.
Altogether.
And he's like, hey, let's go to fucking anywhere in America. I'll be like, alright, cool. If you want to do it, I'll do it. Mm-hmm. My family can't do that. They can't do that for me. They can't motivate me to fucking leave this house. I'm pretty sure if I had a girl...
I motivate you to stay in the house.
I'd be like, hey, man, you know you should lose some weight or stop drinking soda. I'm pretty sure that a girl would do that. I'd be like, hey, man. Or even the other way around. You know how you guys think... I know you guys think how I don't watch porn or I don't really fucking enjoy, like... pornography or nudity or whatever. I'm pretty sure if a girl would put it on and be like, hey, we're watching this movie. All right, cool.
But
it's fucking weird.
But that's the thing. That's I don't get that.
I think
at all.
I'm just what is that when you fucking at the end of the when you get dominated?
You're submissive.
I think that's what it is. I just need someone to tell me fucking what to do.
Like, oh, okay. Like a good woman.
Like
God.
A good woman.
Oh, and
there's been
rumors that, like, you know, Will Smith's been gay as the day is long, right?
Oh, yeah.
And that all
oh,
those...
man, me and her just had a conversation about all the fucking hip-hop artists that I know were gay that turned out to be gay. And
that's
I'm
cool.
Like,
I mean, when you get money, you can do whatever the fuck you want.
Yeah, it's true.
Pretty
it's not gay when you got money.
It's true.
It's just what you're bored for, buddy. Well, no, I just think about that. I mean, like, all these things I've done in my life and shit was because I was more at the end of the thing. Mm-hmm. Like, back in high school, one of the girls I used to go out with hated my truck. She fucking hated the shit out of my old Ford.
Yeah.
Because when I got it, it was my dad's old construction truck.
Yeah.
All right, she's the reason. She motivated enough to fix it. I put in new liners for the seats. I put in a new rug. I changed the fucking window. Mm-hmm. I put in fucking tint. I put in speakers. Put new wheels. Everything. I made the truck look nice. It's like, oh, this is better.
Yep. You know what happened to that girl? She went with the nigga with the Chevy.
Pretty much. And my first year of college, I was going out with a girl. She's like, you know what, dude? You could stand and lose fucking weight. I lost weight. Right. To a point, my mom was like, hey, you sick? Yeah. I was like, no, what? I'm just trying to lose weight. She's like, why? Don't worry about it. Just doing it. But it was just, it was a girl in my ear being like, hey, man, lose some weight. I was like, cool. And I was like, and I was thinking about it. I don't remember this at all. I was like, fuck, I need that in my life. And I just, when I became a shut-in, that just stopped being a possibility. Mm-hmm. And now, I don't know. But I was thinking about it. Mm-hmm. It just stuck in my head. That I always need challenges and always think.
Yeah.
I need goals. And if I'm not, I'm going to be okay just living everyday life the way I live without change.
Yeah.
I need someone to say, hey, you need change. You need to fucking do this. You need to do that.
But it's not just anybody, though.
It's not just anybody.
Because, like, perfect example, like, me and John, who care about you a lot, tell you stop drinking
soda. That's real gay.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck.
But yeah.
You and John are the worst ones, because then I used to tell John, you shouldn't do that. He's like,
I know. I know you guys. But everybody, like, in this fucking house will tell me.
Just like, stop.
Hey, dude, soda's going to kill you. Stop.
Yeah, stop.
Then I ask him why. He's like, oh, you know, for your better health. Not good enough.
I ain't tell you that. I tell you, drink your soda.
But if I had a girl, I'd be like, either stop drinking, give me an ultimatum, either just stop drinking soda, I'm going to leave. Mm-hmm. I'd be like, all right, soda's gone.
She's probably going to be
gone. If I actually liked her, I'd be like, all right, I don't need soda.
Okay, so you got your liger.
I need ultimatums. I think that's what it's called, right?
Ultimatums? We got ultimatums in the back.
Anyways.
Like, that's a tough one.
You think so?
You know why that's hard for you?
I'm a very... weird person.
You know why that's hard for you? Because you gotta find a girl who actually likes you as you are now, but doesn't like you enough to like you.
I want someone to like me now, but be like, hey, you could be better.
No. I mean, I'm serious. He wants a chick to be like, hey, I like you, but I don't fucking love you because you're fat. Yeah. And you talk weird. And so he's going to go to linguistics things and lose weight.
I would actually.
And then she's like, I don't even know who the fuck you are. And then boom, depression hits. Fat again. He slurs all his shit because he's doing Quaaludes. Nobody does Quaaludes anymore, bro.
They're not even made anymore.
that's actually the perfect example. If a girl goes, I like you. Mm-hmm. I would actually, you know, go out with you if you lost a couple pounds. Mm-hmm. I would fucking make it my daily challenge to lose weight. Just be like, okay. Just give her that chance.
I want to see if that's possible. No one does that no more.
No one gives people chances like that. Because, again, they want instant gratification. It's like, I want you because I want you now the way you are. No one wants to put in time and effort.
I blame Bruno Mars for that.
When's the last time you saw a girl give time and effort for a broken people?
All the time.
Well, that's the thing. Is like, that's one thing that I learned with Clarissa. That, like, when we were dating. Like, before we actually started dating...
She stopped listening.
She stopped listening. It doesn't matter. But the thing is, like, she even told me, like, you know, there was a time where I was just... remember when I had the fucking... when I had the blazer? Mm. And it was a piece of shit. And, like, I smoked like a fucking chimney.
I love that.
I just fucking drank constantly. Like, we would just fucking go out and drink.
That was when you were in love with Jack Daniels.
It wasn't that bad, but yeah.
It was with his brother.
You weren't there for most of it.
I remember Roman when he used to drink. He'd go, hey, Roman, what are you doing? I was just drinking with my brother the weekend.
Yeah, I was just drinking at home. Yeah. Like an alcoholic.
I used to call him and say, what are you doing?
Wouldn't even invite.
No, because I don't like people at my house.
Yeah, I don't think you ever conversated with Roman, Cole. I go, hey, Roman, what you do with me? I just drank with my fucking brother.
Yeah.
Or my dad.
I would just drink.
That's when his Jack Daniels and Jack Daniels honey was the love of his life. Yeah, I do remember Clarissa.
I just used to have a bottle of Jack in my room, just fucking swing it every once in a while.
I remember Clarissa made you stop smoking. Yeah. I was like, hey, why don't you smoke it anymore? It's like, she don't like it.
She don't like it, yeah. But the thing was, like, even, like, I had stopped smoking, and then I was just like,
I thought it was because you had that scare when you were like, oh, and I was like, oh, dude, it hurt when I fucking coughed.
Oh, no, that just turns out my body's shit. Oh, okay. No. I quit smoking the first time because of her, and then, like, we just stopped talking, and then I was just like, you know what, like, I actually like...
way you felt?
I liked the way I felt, and then, like, I started going to the gym more, and I was just like, man, this fucking Blazer just keeps shitting out on me, and I don't want to put any more money in it. Let me get another car, and I got a Jeep and stuff like that. I got a haircut. I started, like, losing weight. Started cleaning up myself. And then Clarissa started, like, being like, hey, what's up? And she even said, like, look, I liked you, but you were a fucking bum. You didn't want to better yourself at all, and nobody wants a fucking bum.
So oh, like wants a fucking
everywhere I see, there's just bums everywhere.
But the thing is, like, it's fine to have motivation from someone else, but you have to have that. You have to try to motivate yourself. Yeah, but
the thing. The thing is, it started because of her.
It started because of her.
What I need. I need to find someone that lets me start.
And it kept maybe, on going because maybe. Of her.
But. You've...
And you pursued her, so but, it kind of continued?
Not really, because, like, it was, like, a whole year where, like, I really wasn't concerned with her. I think she was still dating some one of her boyfriends.
But, I mean, back of your head. I mean,
not even.
Deep down, you were like,
yeah,
I don't need this bitch. Fuck this bitch. I can lose weight on my own goddamn
Not at all. I just started, like, I realized, like, oh, I'm not smoking, and, like, I feel a whole lot better. Like, mm-hmm. What would happen if maybe I lost a couple of pounds? Mm-hmm. Like, it's not going to fucking hurt me. And then eventually, I started liking going to the gym. And then I stopped going to the gym because we started dating. And then we started just eating and just, like, fall asleep and all that shit.
She reverted you back.
Yeah, yeah. So, it was her fault.
I like that.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah. I like
next week. You know what, Roman? You ain't shit. Yeah, oh,
I know I ain't shit.
No, I like that. I'm going to make that to a Valentine's card. He's like, you changed me, and you brought me back to this crap I was again.
No, but that's the thing about a relationship is, like, once it starts, like, you're happy, and then, like, all you do is spend time with each other. You eat, and fuck, you're
miserable.
And then eat, and, see, like, just, like, hang out.
You that's know the mean? Thing, though. She's right. No one likes a bum.
Yeah.
And you said that you changed. It started with her, right? Yeah. It started with her. She's like, hey,
she was a catalyst,
right? But you weren't with her as you changed.
No,
it wasn't me. Until you completely changed. Mm-hmm. When she's like, hey, what's going down? Mm-hmm. I can't have that. I need someone to stick with me while the change happens. I want someone to be the catalyst. Mm-hmm. Be like, all right, hey, keep going. Because the moment they stop, I'll be like, oh, I'm okay with who I am.
I mean, but again,
that's my mentality.
But that's, like, too much to ask of a person.
It is.
Like, that's not fair.
That's why I'm
not alone. Maybe you just tell me that you're all right being fat.
Nah, I mean, I keep drinking. It's like, look at the way I live. I say I want to change, but without that motivation, I just get by.
I mean, the thing is that, like, it sounds fucking super simple, but change is hard.
It is.
So you have to, like...
I don't have a goal in buying change. Look, my family says, oh, don't you want to do this? My nieces go, oh, we want to go to the park with you. We want to go to Disneyland and shit. That ain't my job. That's a parent's job. I always tell my mom, if I would fucking die today, everybody would be alright. My nieces have their parents, have their grandma. They have the rest of the uncles, my nephews too. I have no motivation really to change. Why? And they're like, oh, don't you care about this and that? Why? They're not my problem at the end of the day.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, they're not my problem. They're not my concern. If I would go away, they'll be taken care of. It would be life every day. They just wouldn't have someone to, you know, cook, clean, and do all this shit.
So then that doesn't seem okay.
They wouldn't have the butler they have now. But it's not enough motivation for me to change.
But
I don't have that drive. Even though, you know, my nieces and you all guys say, oh, Tony, I wish you would stop drinking soda, you know, get healthier and do this and that, get out of the house and fucking, you know, explore and whatever, right? Yep. Mm-hmm. And my simple question is why?
I don't say that. I tell you, keep on drinking, stay in the house.
But right, my simple question is why? And they're like, oh, because we want to see this. Yeah, but say, at the end of the day, if me getting healthy and shit doesn't affect you guys.
No.
And I was like, okay. But again, my mentality.
And that's the thing, is like, that's where that motivation.
But I need something to motivate me. Something to drive me.
But inevitably, like, that motivation can't come from another person. Like, it has to come from you.
It has to.
And unfortunately.
Because remember when I start, like I said at the beginning of this year, I was like, oh, I want to go to school and learn this.
Yeah.
YouTube teaches me.
Yeah.
I want to learn Japanese. Learning off fucking Facebook. Mm-hmm. There is no fucking motivation for me to go back to school. Because now it just becomes...
That's a whole other thing
entirely. That's the thing. You know what? That's the thing. I could find an excuse for everything. Yeah. I could find an excuse for everything and be like, I don't need to do it anymore. Mm. That's the thing. I'm better at looking at excuses than being... I need a fucking go. I want actual, like, oh, I could do this.
I mean, yeah. I can
tell by your stomach that you can find excuses.
That's like, the thing. Like, for a while,
excuses and snacks.
Oh, dude, that's for a while. For a while, we're having a problem, and finding comfortable clothes for me. Mm-hmm. Found a store that fucking carries it. Mm-hmm. I'm like, hey, I can get as fat as I want. There's clothes for me.
But you don't got the money to pay it all the time. But, your fat ass.
But
they said money was a factor. I got a job now. I could, you know, put money away where I could find clothes.
Barely.
Well, I mean, it sounds like you might have to.
But then again, you know. I gotta kind of go back to the psychologist and whatever.
Yeah, you know, that's what it sounds like because. I mean, the thing is, like, what I'm hearing is just like.
Help me!
What's it called? What today I was doing? I was sad fishing. I think is it sad fishing? Pity fishing.
Yeah,
I want that pity party.
Yeah, the thing is, like, I don't. I can't. Maybe you could shed some light on it, but like. You know, most of the time this comes from fear of something, like a fear to, like, look, like, really just look at yourself, like, you know,
we don't have enough mirrors.
There's not a mirror big enough to hold all this.
Like, I'm not talking about that, I'm talking about, like, you as a person, like, it's hard to examine yourself. And see what kind of a real person you are.
See, but that's the thing. I examine myself and I know what I am.
But that's the thing.
That's the thing. Like, I know what's killing me. I know what's bringing me pain.
Yeah.
I know what's making me fat. Mm-hmm. I know the solution.
There's
knowing's half the battle.
The thing is, like, that's part of it, yeah. But there is something that you're blocking out. Completely, and that's something that you're gonna have to do if you can get to a therapist.
Nah, fuck that. I just want my money. Fuck doctors.
You're seeing that's another
thing.
On
that note, Robin, enough of this pity party. Let's get to some
ain't
comments.
Ain't no pity party. This nigga, you trying to dive deep, and this nigga trying to deflect. Look at your bitch ass. You scare as fuck. You got molested while you was a kid by a black man? That's what happened.
Everybody does. Everybody does deflect, but.
I could hear Mark already be like, fucking, what is it? What do you used to call? Psychology cast? No, I forgot what he did. He used to be, the last time we talked like that, he's fucking, Mark is, he's like, something cast. Anyways,
fair enough.
Can't remember the words.
The thing is, like, I don't know. I mean...
I have a weird way of thinking of things.
It's not weird, it's sad.
I have a sad way of thinking of things.
There you go.
I wouldn't say sad.
Own your sadness.
It's not, and it's not weird. It's just that's the way you think. But there's a reason to the way that you think. Like, I was thinking with the meditation thing, like, you know, it's just guided, so it just gives you the music and stuff, and it's like, well, try to focus on the now, and if they always say, like, if a thought comes into your mind, acknowledge a thought, know that thought, and then just let it go and clear the mind again. Like, focus on the now, focus on your breathing, focus on the moment. Mm-hmm. And that's helped me with a couple of things where I was like, oh, shit. Like, some things I don't want to say.
Epiphanies?
Yeah, some things I don't want to say on the podcast and things I'm not ready to tell anybody because they're kind of fucked up.
No, but so like I'm there. Like,
damn, did you beat a little black kid in the back of the head on top of the pool? Realized, you don't swim? His old fucking Ray fucking on the pool where you killed him?
How crazy would it be if I just, like, I looked off in the distance and just fucking started crying?
Damn, you know what it is? You know, he realized he does have a kid in Colorado that he's fucking been ignoring. He started, he thought about it, he's like,
bum ass dad who killed a little black kid in the fucking pool.
Nah, dude, he went back, he's like, damn, I did come in that bitch. He probably does have my kid. There's like a percentage that goes from like 5%, like, oh, my, I have a kid, to like 80%, oh shit, I better go to Colorado and just check it. Maybe I have
no kids. Nah, fuck it, it's too late, dude.
It's too late, she's already fucked up. She's already gonna be a stripper and gonna marry John.
Yeah.
But anyway, what we got on the fucking comments, Roman?
You're not gonna tell people how to.
You can hit us up on YouTube, SoundCloud. if you wanna do it the old school way, you can hit us on the email. How's that, Roman?
CityPod88@gmail.com. Eric?
That's CityPod88@gmail.com.
You guys want to be part of this psychological talk and share your Valentine's Day stuff?
Also, you're just going to erase my shit and then do it again?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you can go and visit us on our social media. We have Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Just search out Grimworks. You leave a comment there for any of the podcasts you want to.
That's pretty much all I said.
And you could go to youtube.com/Grimworks and drop a comment there like these fine people did. Roman, what's up with them?
All right, well, we only have one person that did. It's time to keep it regs with a prune. All right, so you said lower your standards and share a 3D printed girlfriend. Sharing is caring.
Oh, there you go. I think that's what I need.
Man, first of all, he can't tell me about lowering standards. That nigga, he
and apparently he can't share chicks with his homies.
Exactly. Or their fucking family members and shit. Let alone that nigga fucking done. He scored oil and he ain't even letting us have a little piece of the pie. Which is a weird thing to say. Send nudes, dog.
No.
Alright, fine. Don't send nudes.
You know.
Whatever.
Prune is not that man.
No.
Could be.
He could be.
Anything's possible.
He could be, but he's better than us.
Anyways,
so it's not
happening. What else does he have to say?
I wouldn't say he's better.
His next comment. This podcast is a career killer. if we had careers, that'd be, you know, something.
That'd be something. That'd be like, it come down to career killing podcast. Yeah.
It's a career killer and a career starter, my friend.
Mm-hmm.
His next comment. Out of all the music tracks on CBS2, why this true love making? Why not Real Eyes or Fight with the Wind?
Because that's the only one Roman knew at the moment.
I forgot
he was a fucking real, like, nerd when it comes to the soundtracks.
Yeah, well, the thing is, like, that was the only one that came up with a video. Mm. Like, there was no other ones that had that. Because it was just a video on Facebook, and mm-hmm. I just remembered that, and I remembered the stage, and I was like, oh, man, I like that.
I forgot he collected soundtracks. Mm-hmm. Like, the Kings of Fighters and stuff I used to mm-hmm. get, I just gave it to him.
Yeah.
I sent it to him.
Yeah, they're cool. I actually wanted to check on Spotify to see if they had the CBS2 soundtrack. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that's the reason why. Not that I don't like those songs either. It's just, you know, that was the only one that was available to me at the point.
One of them got erased when he's like, he cringed or it triggered him. Mm-hmm. That's where I got
you. Well, he says, LOL, at 1:15, Tony telling, Tony thinking it was Third Strike immediately triggered me.
Yeah. I don't know my music like you do. Dang.
I mean,
you
don't know.
I get shit confused.
Apparently, you didn't know music or games.
I knew it was a video game song.
But you thought it was Third Strike, dog.
Does not sound like.
No, it does not.
See, I have a weird brain. I have a broken brain, so I ain't prone.
See, no, it was just you mistaked it. That's all. There was no if then like, but oh, yeah, it's not right, my brain's bad, broken. It's you just didn't
understand. Hey, dude,
exactly.
That was his first weed.
You weren't like, you know, like. I don't understand what that is, but anyways.
It's what Shino does. Not Shino, fucking
anime character.
What's his name?
Okay. But the thing is, you made a mistake. Just acknowledge the mistake. And his last comment, just imagine in 30 years Kim Kardashian or Kylie Jenner will be seen as Marilyn Monroe. Maybe. I mean, honestly, I don't care anymore. Previously stated at the beginning of this podcast, I don't understand this new generation and trends.
Do you think Kim Kardashian's pretty? Or her sister?
No, and she's...
Well, not pretty, but sexually attractive.
I mean, I don't know. No, mm-hmm. I don't find her sexually attractive. And I saw her porn. I saw her porn, and I was like, fucking boring as fuck.
Yeah, she sucks.
She looks boring as fuck.
Yeah, she wasn't even good in the bed or anything like that.
You know what it fucking looks like?
Paris Hilton sucked that sucking dick, too.
Yeah.
It would seem if the Kardashians were in the room, right? Mm-hmm. They wouldn't be able to hold a conversation. All would they be doing is taking fucking just pictures. Mm-hmm. Being like, living in the moment. Crazy times. Bitch, you ain't doing nothing but sitting on the fucking couch taking pictures. That's what I think of.
Oh, when I went to go eat at Panda Express today, I saw the funniest thing. One chick was there to eat, and the other chick was there to let people know that they were there. Because the fucking China, she was just like eating. And I was like, damn, China, you get it. But I gotta see some ID. And either way, you probably get it. And then the other one was just like this. She was like, and she was trying to make sure that her friend who had her hair down like this and she was eating, is like, put up your hair a little bit, come on. And I was just like, damn, bitch, let her eat. Fuck, she hungry.
Yeah. She keeps and I
almost
stuck
the phone out of her hand and be like, fucking quit it, Judge.
Triggered.
Telling me people go to restaurants to eat and not take pictures?
Yeah, that's why, like, every time, like, John takes a picture, I'm just, like, stone-faced because I'm just like, I don't want to do this. I don't do this fucking picture thing. Yeah. I don't need
that. But that's not the only thing John's going to make you do. You know what I'm saying? Valentine's Day.
you can get butt raped by John.
About boom boom. Let me hear you say hey ho. Hey ho.
I said boom boom. Hey ho. Hey ho. And that was Keeping the Regs with the Prude.
Thank you for the comments. You know... you were saying that all this conversation between the shit with Liam Neeson and the Me Too, the way we're thinking, the meditation and shit. Mm-hmm. I found a YouTube dude where he was going on the right side of things rant.
Okay.
And I was like, oh my God, why am I agreeing so much shit with him? Mm-hmm. I was like, did I change that? I don't... Because you know how you call me a bigot? Mm-hmm. And I was like, I'm not a bigot. Mm-hmm. I was like, no, I think I probably do hate happiness. Mm-hmm. And people that tell me, I was like... But he was saying, he was going around going, oh man, America's soft. Fucking, we're making our generations weaker. People are too easily hurt. Mm-hmm. People are afraid of doing shit. And he's at the end of it, he's like, you know what? Teach your kids to build shit. Teach your kids that they don't deserve shit. That the hard work you do as a parent shouldn't be something they get to live through. Don't give them shit. Make them earn it. And then he was talking about how there is a dude in California. I think they passed the whole, they get $15 now as like fry cooks and shit. And he's like, you know, that's part of the fucking problem. Because if you give people $15 for being a fry cook, they're going to think that's a fucking career instead of a stepping stone. Mm-hmm. He goes, we're being really fucking stupid right now. Because if you tell them, hey man, you're earning $7.90, whatever, $7.50 an hour because they want you to be a stepping stone. Mm-hmm. You want to earn $15, make it to management. You want to work for McDonald's that bad. Mm-hmm. And you want to make big bucks where you could support a fucking family. Mm-hmm. Earn it. Don't cry about it. Don't beg for it. Don't say, oh, we deserve shit. Or it's, you know, our right. No. It's supposed to be a stepping stone. Mm-hmm. You're supposed to want to be in management so you could get those big bucks. Mm-hmm. And then they come out. And there's the same dude. He goes, oh, I got $15. But the price of milk is like at $5 now. Mm-hmm. He's like, I didn't think the cost of living was going to go up too. Stupid. That's what happens when you fucking... raise the wages on people, the cost of living around you is going to go up.
Yep.
And it's going to be, guess what? You didn't win because it's the same shit.
Yep.
If you were at $7 and you're going to be paying $2 or $3 for a gallon of milk, it's the same thing you being at $15 and paying $5 to $6 for a gallon of milk. But you motherfuckers don't think of it. You just don't want to work hard for it.
Yeah.
You don't want to fucking work hard at all. You don't want to earn shit. You just want shit given to you. He's like, and he was like, stop crying about it. You want to do shit? But he goes, you're part of the problem. Because you're over here like, yeah, they're right. They're fucking victims and we need to change that. No. Fucking make your kids dig a hole in the back. Learn, teach them how to garden. Teach them how to fucking make chairs. Teach them how to change their own oil instead of going, hey, we got to go change the oil. We'll take it someplace. But you have to do it as a parent. You have to do it as a teacher. You have to do it as someone that wants to make sure America changes for the great.
But if everybody's changing their own oil, then you lose jobs for people that change the oil. And other mechanics. Unless they stay as mechanics. In which case they have the tools and technicians.
That's not this point.
No, I hear it. I'm just saying.
Each time someone goes, I'm a victim, go, all right, what are you going to do about it? Mm-hmm. You're going to keep crying about it?
Hell yeah.
Or you learn from it? He goes, there's victims every fucking day. There's always going to be a sad story. There's always going to be a soft story. There's always going to be a pity party. But what are you going to do from it? Mm-hmm. Are you going to learn from it? Are you going to grow from it? Or are you just going to keep bitching and whining until someone goes, oh man, I feel bad for you. Here's all this shit. Mm-hmm. You go, you're not helping that person. You're actually making them worse. Because now everybody has the fucking soft stories. And like, oh, look. They got money because they got fucking whatever happened.
You're giving everybody a fish and not teaching them how to fish.
And I was like, oh my God, this dude is making so much fucking sense. Mm-hmm. He was like, man, you tell someone they're... And it reminded me of a stupid comment I made on Facebook where you don't give a crying kid what they want. Because at the end, that's how they're always going to ask for shit now. Mm-hmm. They know that if they start crying, they're going to get what they want. Mm-hmm. That's what these fucking people were doing now. All these Me Too movement, all these soft kids, they're... crying at old kids. And America's kind of giving them...
Me Too is a different thing.
No, though. Man. Look, shit happens.
Me Too's the raping thing.
Yeah, shit happens, man. That's what the point is. Like, shit happens.
Yes.
And...
Go do your thing.
I have this thing where, like, alright, bad shit happens to you. Mm-hmm. Bad shit's always gonna happen. It's the way of the world.
The world ain't fair, baby.
But sometimes, I don't know, it's better to be silent about it. Again, that's my way. I don't think you get people convicted, because then, I don't know, there's...
I think you get them convicted when it happens right then and there.
Yeah, it has to. If you're going to fucking talk about
that's
shit like that...
That's instant gratification.
Yeah, if you're going to... If something happens to you, you have to act on it when it happens.
Strike while the iron's hot.
Don't wait 10 fucking years. Don't wait until someone goes, oh man, this dude did something, and you're like... Oh, guess what? He did it to Me Too. Isn't that what Me Too is?
Yeah.
When they're like, someone finally speaks out and they're like, yeah, it happened to Me Too. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't matter the time period. Or did I get that wrong?
It seems no, right. You got it right. The thing is that...
Look, dude, if something bad happens, like I said, mm-hmm. bad shit's always going to fucking happen. Mm-hmm. Say it then. Mm-hmm. Do something about it then.
Mm-hmm. Boondock Saint style.
Don't fucking wait 5 years. Don't wait 10 years. Don't even wait fucking a month. Shit happens to it. Don't be afraid. Fucking report it. Do something about it.
Mm-hmm. But the fear, it takes over.
All right?
Yeah.
Or if you decide not to talk about it, stick with that. Mm-hmm. Either make your choice. Either fucking go, hey man, something just happened to me. And do something about it. But you can't have both. You can't. It's making a bad reality for what we're becoming.
It's like being bisexual. You gotta choose one.
Oh yeah. But I don't know, all this was just like, oh man. And I was, like I said,
so does that mean you're now thinking like a Republican? Congratulations.
Oh yeah, fuck it. People have to work for what they want. There is this,
if possible.
There is this,
If you was born without like a leg or an arm, but you still try, good for you, bro.
Oh no, look. There is this dude in motivation goes, you want to earn something, put a picture of it in front of your face every day. Drive. Go. This is what motivates me. Simpson style. Mm-hmm. Remember that Simpson where he covers all the bad words?
Yeah, don't forget about her.
Yeah, yeah. Or doing it for her. Mm-hmm. Kind of dear. You want that. You want a nice car? Mm-hmm. Work your ass off for it. Mm-hmm. Put that nice car in front of you. Put it in your phone, look at it, go, okay, this is the reason I'm working so far for.
I think I remember a joke from that one. There's a guy put a picture of a guy wanted to lose weight. He put a picture of a, a dude with like a six pack of abs just turned him gay.
No, but I've seen people where you go, you want a nice house, put a picture of that.
It's
nice.
It's called
house
a vision phone. Board.
Yeah, visionize it. I have my older brother works at a warehouse. He's like, yeah, man, there's this one dude that has a really nice truck, and my brother likes talking about guns. He's like, man, he has a pretty decent gun collection. I go, how does he get it? Well, this dude doesn't sleep. He's like, anybody wants a shit cover, he goes and covers it. And he stays there extra hours. I was like, that's how you do it. And he's like, oh, but I'm married with kids. He's like, talk to your wife. Go, hey, man, can you cover me this day?
Does the guy have extra kids?
Work and shit? No, he's single. But look at our friends. John goes, I want to work for a house. He better himself. He goes, I'm not going to stay at that old job. He changed locations. He changed job titles. Mm-hmm. Now we barely hang out with him because he's really working so much. Mm-hmm. But what does he say each time he comes around? He's like, hey, man, my money is starting to look better. Mm-hmm. Why? Because he goes, I want a house by this year. Mm-hmm. Gives him some motivation. Look at Daniel. Mm-hmm. Daniel's like, oh, I want to get out of the hood. Mm-hmm. I want a girl to like me. Like, for who I want to be. Mm-hmm. He better himself. He got a fucking real... Sure, the job was by chance. Mm-hmm. But, oh man, he fucking worked stupid hard for that job.
The thing... Well,
it's not by chance. I mean, at first, yeah. But he knew the lady.
But ever since I ever talked to... Like, a serious conversation with him, he's like, I want to better myself. I do not want to end up in the hood. I don't want to end up like his friends. He used to say his friends, you know, the low people in low places kind of friends. And he better himself. Now, he's happy, he has a really good job. Look at our other friend, walking. He's like, I don't want to stay here. And that motherfucker, we used to make fun of him. He's like, hey, dude, why are you fucking all this? Like, well, you don't hang out because you're always at school and working. Mm-hmm. That motherfucker is living the life now in New York.
He sure is.
And I was like, God damn, all these things are just, that's what I need. I need, what was it called? An image board? A vision board? I need to fucking... start earning what I want. Find what I want to, what I want first.
First of all, get a real job out of the house.
Get a fucking real job, you know. Change that. And I started thinking about, you know, or the Grimworks company. I'm putting so much shit in motion. I was like, oh, I have a goal now. I have a goal at the end of the year that I want to at least be recognized.
He wants to bring back two fools.
I want to bring back two fools.
There you go.
Alan. Oh, the dude just... open my eyes to a lot of shit.
And then you opened up his butt to him.
And I opened up my butt to him.
There you go. On that note, bye.
On that note, this has been episode
130
of the City Podcast. And we have been your hosts. I'm Tony, and I'm here with...
Roman.
Your boy, Eric.
Hate that boy. And like we say at the end of every episode, bye.